Into Ukraine we go, where more deadly missile strikes have rocked the country overnight. Russian President Vladimir Putin has threatened there'll be more to come. We can take a look at a map of where the targets have been. As you can see, Kiev there, the capital, that has been the subject of many attacks, but it is throughout the country. And we're heading to Lviv right now, where Newshub Europe correspondent Lisette Raymer is. Lisette, it has been quite the journey for you to get back into Lviv. Tell us about that.
Yeah, Melissa, we woke up early this morning thinking we would be able to cross over the border from Poland to Ukraine like we have four other times without much issue. However, as soon as we got through the Polish side, we went through to cross through to Ukraine, and all of a sudden you could tell something was happening because the Ukrainian border force was instantly on edge. They started yelling at us to move back. We weren't the only ones in line, and it took us a little while to realise what had happened, but that was the point that these strikes had started across the country. So at that point, because of how many there were and just how unsettling it was for everyone, even on the far west where we were, they closed the border temporarily. Part of that was safety, but also because of the infrastructure that was hit by these strikes, the computer systems across Ukraine, particularly along the west side at the border, shut down. There was no electricity, there was no way for them to process people getting to and fro the country, out of the country. So we were held there for quite some time before they considered us to be worthwhile processing manually. They got us across the border and we made our way through to Lviv. But instantly there was talk of more checkpoints being set up on the journey into the country. Often you'll see one or two on the way into Lviv. We saw a number more just because of the increased uncertainty and just how unsettled people instantly felt, understandably so, because of this barrage of missiles that Putin dropped this morning all across the country.
Yeah, and a little later on, you'll give us the latest on that. We're also speaking with a security expert, international security expert, just after seven. I'm interested to know, are there a number of people moving around, or is there a sense of panic? Are people locked down because they don't know how long these retaliatory attacks will last?
What's really interesting and what has struck me coming into Lviv, you know, we have been here many times and there is almost a strange sense of normality in Lviv. It is so close to Poland. People feel quite safe here. For example, I mean, I've never had to have body armour right next to me in a live cross when I've stood in Lviv. It's never been considered that high risk. It's never been that necessary to be prepared for a missile strike, but now it is. And there was definitely that sense today around the city that, yes, we are still in one of the safer places, but there were strikes here this morning and it rattles people instantly and it makes them genuinely fearful for their lives. A lot of people have expressed to me they're very worried about this evening, what's going to happen when the sun goes down, how they're going to get through the evening. And for example, one of the other things that happened today is halfway through the day, we just started hearing murmurings throughout the square, throughout a cafe that we were at, that there was going to be another missile drop similar to this morning at 4 p.m. And at that time it was 3:20, and it kind of just spread around the cafe like wildfire. People, you could tell, were hearing this news, but not really sure where it was coming from because we had huge connection issues with the internet, with electricity today. So none of it was particularly verified. And previous trips to Lviv, no one would pay much attention to that. People rarely go into basements where they hear ear sirens, but today felt different. It felt like those warnings were being really listened to. It feels like if there was an ear raid siren right now, everybody in this city would head to a basement. So that is a noticeable difference.
And Lisette, you said people were worried about what it's going to be like when the sun goes down. Looking behind you, there's only a tiny flicker of light. It looks like it's very dark.
Yeah, it's essentially a blackout in Lviv at the moment. The lights that you can see are being, you know, powered by generators. A lot of hotels have generators, which mean they can put on a little bit of electricity. But all day today, the networks have been down. The missile that struck here in Lviv hit one of the major pieces of energy infrastructure. Four regions across Ukraine at the moment are without power, and Lviv is one of them. They're desperately trying to get that back up again. But as you say, it is a blackout here. It's been the same with phone networks for the most part of today. We couldn't get any sort of message out to anyone. Internet was down. There was no way to get any information. And that is an incredibly unsettling and concerning position to be in when you're someone living here in Lviv, not just because you want to tell other people that you're safe, but you also want to be able to check in on your loved ones who could be anywhere else in this country, where at the moment missiles are falling all over the place. So there is a real sense that nowhere is safe. And when you add this blackout layer where there's no way to communicate, no way to hear news, no way to get the warning that there are missiles coming, That is incredibly unsettling, and that's why people are so worried about this evening and what plays out.
Ukraine has been hit by multiple missiles overnight, killing at least 11. Joining us live from Lviv with the latest, Newshub Europe correspondent Lisette Raymer. Lisette, thanks for being with us again. What is the latest we know about the targets and the damage that these missiles have inflicted?
More than 80 missile strikes, Melissa. This has been a hugely horrific and alarming day for all Ukrainians, especially because it has been a barrage across the country, not just in the east where the fighting has been most recently, but also in the west. A safe haven like Lviv has been hit, also in the south, and perhaps most importantly or alarmingly in the north, in Kyiv, in the capital, a place that hasn't had a strike like this in some months. Hasn't been a strike like this, in fact, since June. So it has been hugely alarming for those residents. A lot of them forced back into the basements, into the undergrounds, subway systems, taking shelter and riding this out because they are, once again, fearing for their lives in the capital. Russia has claimed that they were only targeting the military infrastructure. When you look at a place like Kyiv, it is hard to believe, given a lot of those residential areas, those densely residential areas, have been hit and have been, you know, the scenes of fatal incidents. Some we saw an attack that landed, a missile attack that landed not far from a major university, not far also from President Zelensky's office. So a lot of questions now being asked or being raised yet again by the EU, by President Biden, about just how much longer President Putin can continue with these barbaric attacks. Russia has indicated that it was a response to the attack on the bridge that joins the annexed territory of Crimea with Russia. That was a prized bridge for Putin. He has taken that explosion very personally, and this is the result. But an incredibly unsettling day for everyone here in Ukraine. That's not to say that some infrastructure wasn't hit. It certainly was. 11 major sites were hit by missiles, and that has left four regions across Ukraine, including Lviv, where we are at the moment, completely lacking electricity. A lot of them, including Lviv, are still without running water. So a very unsettling evening ahead for everyone in Ukraine.
And as you were saying earlier, Lisette, Lviv typically has been a somewhat of a safe haven in Ukraine. And one of the targets actually hit very near a children's playground, left a large hole there. So, yeah, as you say, it has been indiscriminate in some places. Newshub Europe correspondent Lisette Raymer reporting live on the ground in Ukraine from Lviv this morning. Thanks for your time.